The argument put forward by the countries where the four-day workweek has been implemented is that if the benefits of new technologies are to be evenly spread around, workers can have a shorter working week without loss of pay, and productivity can be increased, as in the case of organizations in New Zealand and Sweden. It seems like a win-win situation for workers and employers alike. The argument is that not only do happier workers become more productive, but they also feel a greater sense of commitment to their employer under such working conditions. In St. Lucia, Executive Director of the St. Lucia Employers Federation, Joseph Alexander, says productivity is already an issue here, and implementing the four-day work week will not help in a country that is trying to attract investors.
But we would have to begin to measure our productivity, because whatever we do, it must be reflected in a way that foreign investors, which is really our hope for the future, must be in line with productivity would be the key.
In the bigger countries, healthcare workers, traditionally women, are often forced to work grueling shifts with significant repercussions on their health and productivity. According to the research, shorter hours reduces the government's welfare expenditure. Hiring more people means lower unemployment, which is a social cost. There are also fewer cases of sick leave, which reduces the burden on the healthcare system. However, it is not all pluses. Overall, hiring more people drives costs up by 20% to 30%, but in the long run, it reduces unemployment and healthcare expenses by 15%. Shorter hours also improved day-to-day interaction and increased daily activities by 60%. However, Mr. Joseph says that when it comes to the technology, the more developed countries are way ahead of St. Lucia, and for the new system to work here, St. Lucia would have to enhance its technology capacity, as the country is still heavily dependent on manual labor.
You see, in these developed countries, technology has improved productivity quite a bit, right? But St. Lucia, we still do a lot of manual labor. A lot of things are still manually done. So once you start to get into the realm where you bring in technology, then we can start looking at something like this.
The new 4-day work week program is working out well in the Netherlands, Denmark, Norway, and Ireland, but in St. Lucia, Mr. Alexander does not see this happening anytime soon. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.